This dropper post is an X-Fusion Manic. You can buy these X-Fusion posts with a lever on eBay for 150 bucks all day or use takeoffs. They work great because you can push the lever with your full weight and get the seat down. This bike over there is an Italian Fantic bike with a semi-externally mounted dropper post cable, so I went for the AXS dropper post. If you're anything like me, you're curious, what is the difference between 150 and 850? Well, it's been a mixed experience with the Rockshox wireless dropper post. First of all, you should know the lever requires like no force to press. So if you had small weak hands or something or an injury, the wireless dropper post is gonna be a better option. You can also micro tune the seat height like 5,000 times while you're climbing. As for the cheap dropper posts, it has a long throw on the lever, so it's a lot harder to micro tune it. So this is the charger for the wireless dropper post. It's a USB old one. My entire existence has been to eliminate those plugs from my life. Why does an $860 dropper post have that? I don't know, ask Tram. So the wireless AXS post, a month later, I haven't rode the bike in a month. I go to ride it, the freaking battery's dead. Super annoying. Then I can't find the charger. It does add a bit of complexity, but it is an amazing piece of machinery with its simplicity. The clamps are much easier to use on the wireless dropper post. The cheapy, it's got the two standard bolts on the bottom. The cheapy works fine. I'm still gonna keep buying these. There's no reason to buy a wireless AXS dropper post for me, unless you had a weirdo bike like this or some like old 26 inch bike, maybe a downhill bike with no cable routing. So the Rockshox wireless post, it's like a piece of suspension. It's a very complex bunch of O-rings. It can be rebuilt. All you can do a cheapy post is put a new cartridge inside of it, which is pretty easy to put in. But the wireless dropper post, you could probably have that for 20 years, rebuild it 20 different times. So technically it could save you money. I've seen a couple videos of the battery on the wireless dropper post scraping the tire. That could be an issue if you have a very small bike. I don't know why this battery is $65, but it is. Another great reason to buy the expensive dropper post, if your frame doesn't really fit you that well and you're looking for a lower standover, with the cable actuated post, it's got an extended bottom for the cable. So this is the farthest I can get that dropper post into the Knievo. As where the Fantic, I can slam it all the way down because that bike has a super long seat tube and I was looking for more standover. I feel like there should have been a lower stack height on the Rockshox wireless AXS post. That's the gap between the bottom and the top. It doesn't have the lowest stack number. If you're looking for low stack, go for the 1UP post. It's got the lowest stack on the market, but for the price of $150 on the X-Fusion post, you really can't go wrong for these. The wireless dropper post, it solves a lot of problems. Like, this is a Brose e-bike motor controller and it's kind of a crappy design, and that Rockshox wireless dropper post fixes the issue. With a normal dropper post, you hit the up and down power button, but with the Rockshox wireless post, it pushes it way down. So there's a lot of issues that Rockshox wireless dropper post fix. Like, I was borrowing a Specialized Knievo SL size S5. It was a little bit too tall for me. It took about 5 minutes to swap seat posts. The wireless dropper post fixes so many issues, like bikes with no cable routing. You can bring your post on vacation, but it's not perfect. The battery situation is pretty irritating. I'm just constantly worried about, is my dropper post cable charged?